Discord right here in Cyberland, USA. This is Podzilla After Dark on the Podzilla 1985 Network. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Seanan Young. I'm going to be your host tonight. With me, of course, without the soundboard, it's not as much fun. We've got the founder of Penta Nerd and the co-owner of a new house coming up, Mr. Jesse Kimball.
Why has Penta Nerd been coming back in the rotation so much lately? Look, nobody remembers Penta Nerd.
Nostalgia's in, man. Everyone wants to live in the past these days. Also, with us
old is new again.
Not shown completely. Lindsay Wolfgang.
I am drawing.
All right. Also with us tonight.
It's the hands there.
Shelby Chan's here with us tonight.
Hello.
I made sure to.
You remembered to introduce her this time.
Yeah.
Thank you. I feel so loved.
And of course, the Kaz Man here with us tonight.
Yo,
he's the Kaz Man.
Kaz Man. Also, guys, tonight.
If is after Loki? So yeah, I think like when me and Ace were talking about it before, we just assumed that it would be another 9-episode season for Falcon and Winter Soldier. And that's why we thought, because if it was 9 episodes, that would take us almost through May. And then at the beginning of June would be Loki. Or no, Loki was originally supposed to be in May and it got pushed. That's what happened.
A little bit of pre-show conversation we had, and I'm sure we'll talk about it again a little bit here more in just a little bit tonight. Tonight on tap, we've got the 5 things coming out that we're gonna do list. It's very
cool. If you guys wanted to hear that pre-show stuff,
go to facebook.com
on Facebook. Yeah, because Seanan goes live with the show before we start.
Normally
you get to hear us talk and warm up and stuff.
I'll go for like 30 minutes to an hour, and if no one's around, I just listen to music with the audience and we shoot the shit. It's actually pretty good. Jesse, tonight we got a sponsor.
What?
Yeah.
Who's that?
XSplit.
Tonight's show is brought to you by Cayman Jack's Margaritas. Hey. Hey. Do you want to drink like your adult friends, but you're too much of a little sissy boy and mommy and daddy are dead so you can't ask permission? Drink Cayman Jack's Margaritas. It won't get you drunk, but it will make you less of a bitch. Cayman Jack's.
Or 7-Up.
You could go with like Mike's Hard or something like that. That would be that's probably a step up from there.
I mean,
further sponsored by Excedrin.
Assuming I could get. I think you have to be good at getting erections to get Mike's Hard Lemonade. So I stick with Cayman Jack.
Hey, somebody said, "Oh, hey, what's up, Shelby?"
It's Chad Gray.
Oh, hey, Chad, how's it going?
Oh, that's why he's here. Okay. I know Chad. He's a good guy, I think, if I remember correctly. Yeah, probably. Okay.
Yeah, he's a good guy.
You have to be sure about these things before you start saying them publicly. Otherwise, you end up like defending people like Matt Gaetz.
Hey, when you're me, once you get 2 Cayman Jack margaritas in you, you never know what you're going to say.
You never know.
Kids,
so what is the 5 principles about?
Kids don't drink.
Yes,
why am I drinking? Thank you for asking. Because I went to the doctor's today, and it was an awkward experience, and I wanted to drink because of it. Jesse, can I tell you another awkward experience that I had? I posted it in the Call of Duty chat, but I don't think you looked at it, probably.
I have not looked at the Call of Duty chat yet, no.
It was yesterday. Did you look at it yesterday?
Maybe.
Well, then I'll tell the story anyway, because it's very funny. And it pertains to this show. So
I'm going to read it while you're telling the story.
Oh, is this the one that you called me about? Because you said you had to tell me over like the video rather than text.
Yeah. Okay. Which, Jesse, you can't actually read about it for the most part. I did the story in audio. So I will tell the story again for people listening. So a little bit of history. When I became single last year, around April-ish, I decided to make the jump into the world of online dating. Jesse, you remember this. I was giving updates on the After Dark back then about how it was going. It went poorly. Well, when Maria and I started dating, I deleted those apps. But I never deactivated them. I just deleted them. So when I reinstalled the apps earlier this year, because I said, you know what, I'm going to take some time to be single, and then maybe down the line, I will pursue something, maybe. Well, this person and I, as I was scrolling through it one night, because it kept giving me notifications that people were liking me. And I thought, well, that's clearly a lie, and I want to see what these robots look like, because I don't trust anybody. So I see this one, and she's a fairly pretty girl. And I go, oh, she's attractive. So I hit like, and it said we matched. And I'm like, oh, okay, cool. And then she messaged me and said that she wanted to hear a ghost story and that she asked me about the podcast. And then I realized, oh, right, I actually mentioned in my profile about the podcast. Well, I tell her all about Podzilla 1985. In fact, it was not romantic in any way. It was literally just an ad. I gave her an ad for Podzilla 1985. You can listen to us on this website. You can find us on facebook.com/Podzilla1985. So the next day we're talking again, and I asked her, you know, I wanted to make sure the podcast, she didn't listen to it and it wasn't so bad that she would like never want to talk to me again because she seemed interesting. And she said, no, you know, no, it's fine. The ghost story I told her was creepy. And then she hit me with this. She said, also, I found out from your podcast that you would fuck a Ditto. And that's why I'm drinking.
Yes!
Oh. Oh, mercy.
How did you recover from that? Or is she still talking? Does that make her more or less interested?
Do I look like I recovered from it?
How do you feel about her?
I actually told her, I said, you know what? This is the best reason I've ever heard to never speak to me again, and I kind of appreciate it. We did talk a little bit after that and joked around a little bit, but that's really all that came of it. But what a story. And now I think I will go delete that dating app and never talk to another person ever again. I'm also deleting this podcast. I'm out.
Oh, it's fucking great. You know, I love on the show, like, you fully admit to it and everything, too. Like, it's not us, like, giving you a hard time or anything. Oh, that's good shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm sorry, buddy.
No, it's fine. I think it's hilarious. I thought it was very, very funny. But then I did worry, you know what? Maybe these things I say out in public will come back and haunt me. Maybe I should stop. Probably. Maybe I should stop saying them.
In fairness, if she gets upset because you'd fuck a Ditto.
Oh no, she wasn't upset. Like, no, she wasn't upset. She laughed about it. We laughed about it.
Just wait to the day that somebody convinces you to run for office.
I already want to run. I already want to run for office. I mean, it couldn't be any worse than Matt Gaetz.
Do it. I mean,
instead of his initials on everything, it's just a Ditto.
Honestly, that would be great publicity for PZ85 if you ran for office.
Yeah.
Is it true?
Why not?
Is it true, Mr. Young, that you've got a podcast? No. Never heard of it.
Nope. Never heard of it.
Different Shannon Young. Okay, but it's also on Facebook. Here's video of you on the podcast. It's not me.
That's not me.
It's not me.
It's not me.
Striking resemblance.
That is my twin brother Seanan.
I'm pretty sure that's a Ditto.
No, it's like, you see how he's wearing the glasses, he's hiding the eyes.
that's actually what she said. She said It would be a little weird because I'm pretty sure they would have those little black eyes, and I'm like, that's only if they do a bad, if they're a bad Ditto, right, Lindsay? I mean, real regular Dittos
that was, fully. That was the episode.
Yeah,
because it was just the Ditto that couldn't fully transform. It had the dumb face. Though we made the jokes before about like, because whenever this first came up, like, yeah, would you fuck a Ditto that looks like Kate Upton even if it had those eyes? And you're like, yeah.
Seanan makes a lot of jokes he wish he hadn't made. In fact, I'm pretty
best
sure
part that they're on the record.
They are, yeah. 99, I'm pretty sure most of the things that have gone wrong in my life are because I just won't shut up
publicly.
But if I didn't have this, what would I have? So, let's see. We haven't done a motherfucker of the week in so long. And we will continue to not do one again because I don't know. Everything that I've kept up with, all of the bad things are really bad. So I don't want to, like, I don't want to make Matt Gaetz the motherfucker of the week because what he's done is a little bit too serious to be joked about. Other than, Kaz, do you have some of those wonderful pictures? Kaz has got us covered on that one, by the way.
I don't know. Maybe. Maybe not. I think I got rid of them just because.
I thought about Joe Manchin, since he's going to derail anything Biden tries to do ever, apparently. He could be the motherfucker of the week.
Well, that's what happens when your state is like 95% looks like you. Imagine, and there's only like 80 people in it.
Imagine if your state, if you were a Ditto and your state looked like you. Boy, that's a hot state. I don't think I could. I couldn't walk through there with a single pair of jeans. I'd be bursting at the seams. My zipper would break open like the gates of hell when Lil Nas X sliding down that stripper pole.
I didn't know where I was going, but I appreciated the landing.
Basically, ladies, what I'm saying is if you came here to find out if I'm a quality content, I'm not. Move on.
Well,
let me keep. I got five more of these in the fridge, I think. So
that's we'll get spectacular. Through it.
Yeah.
What are you guys looking at?
The billboard.
What billboard?
Oh, yeah.
Matt Gaetz wants to date your child. Billboard appears in Florida.
Caleb says, I'm happy when girls pay attention to me. Caleb, it's not as good as it sounds, trust me. Like, sometimes when girls pay attention to you, it's good, and you can build really strong relationships with them. Other times when girls pay attention to you, it's just to let you know that they know that you would fuck a Pokemon, in which case... Those interactions are probably better left unsaid.
That's very funny to me. I'm so sorry, Seanan.
No, it's funny. It's fucking hilarious. Like, it's hilarious. Believe me. I'm not losing sleep over it, brother. Let me tell you.
Yeah, it's its own form of hilarity.
It is. It's like I'm finally recognized for something. Why did it have to be that?
It's going to be on. You're like Seanan Young. Would fuck a Ditto.
You know what I really would have appreciated is if she had said something like, I really appreciate your views on being African American in America. I appreciate your views on gay rights and stuff like that. Now, I really appreciate the way you want to put your penis inside of a gelatinous pink blob. But it would be in human form first, yeah.
Yeah, no, it's not like you're taking the blob and just putting your dick in it. Like, it's transforming.
Well, not better.
Yeah, what do you mean not better? He's not doing that thing.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Apparently Chad Gray wants the blob. Fred, their own.
Fred Dukes or the blob. Anyway, I can't even drink this now. Yeah. So right now I'm missing NXT Stand and Deliver Night 2, which I just wanted to watch for Poppy. There's apparently, Jesse, I don't know if you saw it in the group chat, WWE is releasing a Poppy t-shirt from NXT, and I really want it, but I don't wear t-shirts. But if you want to buy me a t-shirt, you can send it to 709 Broadway, Gaming Grounds, Cape Missouri. What is it? Cape Girardeau.
You just added in a weird order.
Yeah, it's all good.
It's Gaming all Grounds, 709 Broadway, in Cape Girardeau, Missouri, 63701. I like that we're just looking at Lindsay's app. Like, Lindsay, what you got there?
I'm not looking at Lindsay's app.
Which type of Pokemon I'm drawing next?
I'm looking.
It's gonna be a flying type.
I'm looking at Kaz's app. Like, I feel like wanting to fuck a Ditto is 50% less bad than wanting to fuck children, right? Like, I mean,
that wanting to fuck a Ditto is significantly less bad.
I agree.
It's more than 50%.
I bet Matt Gaetz wishes he had a Ditto.
Yes.
He would show it.
I know what that Ditto would look like.
He would show it hours after hours of old Punky Brewster videos and say, be that. This is Hilary Duff from Lizzie McGuire.
Oh.
And Lindsay,
I had a huge crush on her.
I'm about to say, I swear to God, if Lindsay mentions the fact that I had a Hilary Duff poster, I'll kill her.
What do you mean had?
Do I still have it?
Yes.
Burn it. I don't need that evidence. Cass, God damn it. Oh my God. It's a very laid back show tonight. Well, I don't have anything prepared. You need a
picture of Shannon with that caption.
Like, no, you don't. No, you fucking don't. Cass. God damn it.
Yes.
Cass, you son of a... And don't do it. Please just don't make it the picture of me with the arm. And don't make it something like, hey, Ditto, does this get you wet or something? Please stop it, Shannon. Don't give him
are
a hammer.
Are you giving him more fuel?
Yeah.
Oh, God damn it.
No, hey, Shannon, that was a strategy on Shannon's part. He didn't want to... He basically did those things so that Kaz wouldn't, because now Kaz would have been stealing from him. So Kaz has to be original now with whatever he decides to post.
That could be
should
even,
he decide to post anything at all.
That could be even
or
worse.
Or Kaz could just not care and do everything.
Look on Kaz's face makes me think that he's going to post something.
He's my cousin.
I'm not doing anything.
He's my cousin. He's my best friend. All right. Well, while Kaz is about to ruin my life, let's...
Oh no.
Oh.
That's not okay.
Tonight's a very horse time like show, I have a feeling. Let's talk about Ghostbusters for a second, because that gets the heat off me. So they released a clip.
Yeah,
For Ghostbusters Afterlife with the little mini puffs. What'd you think of it?
Adorable and they're mini gremlins.
I'm a little
updated.
I'm a little worried about it because I don't know. Is it too over the top and silly for Ghostbusters? They never had anything that silly in the old movies.
Slimer. Now then again, Slimer wasn't really silly in the movies.
Mm-mm.
He wasn't silly until he got to the show.
Right. And then it wasn't silly. It was just stupid.
Yeah. I'm trying to think if there was anything.
Because it was always more serious. This strikes me as very much a 2016 Ghostbusters thing.
Yeah, the comedy was definitely not
kid friendly.
Like it wasn't with the ghosts. Like the comedy was not about the rest of the comedy was like, you know, when he got head from a ghost and they were sitting there like he was smoking a cigarette afterward.
All right, the ghost head scene was just a dream. So
yeah, well.
Fuck!
Oh my God.
So
you got something new to talk about Michaela with here.
I saw it. I'm ignoring it because I like her. If you're listening to this on Podzilla1985.com and you haven't seen us live, don't watch this one. You don't need
don't
to see
watch this one.
You don't need to see the video that he is presenting, and I don't think you should look at it. Thank you. This is my TED talk.
Yeah, alternatively, though, if you did watch it, you could ignore Kaz's frame if you choose to honor Shannon's wishes, and you could look at Lindsay's frame where she's actually doodling.
Not anymore.
Good point.
I'm deciding which one I want to draw. It's hard.
Coincidentally, she's taking a break from doodling while deciding what she's going to draw.
Coincidentally, it's hard is what I say when nope.
When there's a ditto around.
Stop! Can't you see I'm lonely?
We need to get Seanan a giant ditto plush.
The fuck you do? I don't like this. Why did I bring this joke up?
Here's put those birds on it so that every time it moves, its eyes do that.
All right, so straight up, it's kind of small on my screen, and for a second I thought that said waiting for semen.
That's funny because when I try to type Seanan into my phone, it autocorrects to semen.
just like with that fucking smiley face. It's just got the goofy little smile. It's just waiting for semen.
Oh my.
Oh, it's good stuff. Seanan, why are you not on camera right now?
You want to go get more alcohol, probably.
I fucking need it.
There's too much ditto semen.
That's good shit.
Wait, where did he go?
It just keeps appearing and disappearing. So anyway, what the fuck, Seanan?
I don't know what's happening.
Today is only to entertain ourselves. I don't fucking care about the people listening.
Semen.
Well, where'd you go, baby?
Oh, good. These ditto jokes are fantastic, and I'm here for it.
They sure are. They sure are. Those won't get old.
Nope. No chance in hell of that happening.
No chance that
those won't get old, just like Matt Gaetz's sexual partners.
Oh! Well, no, they'll get old eventually. Don't start that way.
Kaz, you know what Matt Gaetz's favorite thing is about high school girls? He gets older, but they don't.
All right.
Let's just get to the top five for the night. Lindsay, tell us what the fuck it was.
Tonight we were supposed to bring the top five things coming out in various media this year that we're excited for. So, like, movies, video games, TV shows, books, etc.
You know, I went to the doctor earlier this morning. And the doctor asked me if I felt depressed, how often, if it was one or two times a week or whatever, and I told him it was every day. And then they asked me if I had suicidal thoughts, and I told him all the time. And then they looked shocked, and they asked if I had thought of how I would do it, if I actually planned it out. And I said, of course I did. You know, I have all kinds of plans. And then they said, why do you feel this way? And I said, because my cousin keeps posting pictures of me and dittos. And
you are not that's single one of these pictures.
He went back and forth of me flexing. How do you do these so fast? How do you do them so fast?
He's getting typed. Yep. He was just waiting on you. Seanan's gone again.
Yeah, I'm here. What's the list again? Just tell me.
Do I really need to tell you again?
Yeah, I wasn't paying attention the first time because I was still thinking about my own dead life.
Five things in media that are coming out this year you're excited for.
Okay. Are we talking about like Fox or MSNBC or which media?
Movies, comic books.
I know. I'm being difficult for Lindsay. All right.
I wasn't paying attention. I just heard a question.
Yeah, that's fair.
Let's start with the one person. Sorry, so movies, music, something that's coming out this year that we're most excited about, the top five things. Let's start with the person who's making my life the most miserable, Jesse Kimble.
Well, if that's fair, I guess. Black Widow.
No.
I'm excited for Black Widow.
Oh.
Pick a different one.
Alright.
No, I'm kidding. Let's talk about it, because we got to fill time.
Because I think that's supposed to hit this year, too. No, it's not. Wait, Shang-Chi is the other one hitting this year, and isn't there one more?
They pushed it back.
What?
They pushed back Shang-Chi.
Yeah, it got pushed back to, like, September.
Yeah, I think it's still coming
out. Black Widow got pushed.
Caleb also said Black Widow. Sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off there. So Black Widow, yeah. It's been delayed. It was delayed last year. It's coming out this year. I really didn't want to watch it last year. I still don't want to watch it. It'll be okay. I'm not a big Black Widow fan.
I'm intrigued because there's some fan theories floating around, and I want to see if it plays into any of it.
Lindsay, you gotta stop listening to these fan theories. Remember, the fan theories are why Wanda and the X-Men broke me.
Look. I liked that one, even though it didn't go anywhere.
This one
won't go anywhere, but I'm still curious.
But Lindsay,
if it feeds into it.
But Lindsay, they're definitely bringing the X-Men in now because they went to Madripoor.
Oh yeah, I know. Yeah, we'll see when I see Logan.
Logan Paul could make it happen.
No.
Tune into WrestleMania this weekend, where Logan Paul will be on WWE WrestleMania.
Fuck that motherfucker.
Yeah, didn't he? Well, so did he have more than like the two matches where he got his ass kicked in UFC?
They were boxing matches, and he won both of them.
I don't think that's true.
Both Paul brothers, I'm pretty sure, are undefeated in boxing. No, that's not true. Jake Paul's undefeated. Logan got his ass by KSI, and I don't remember if it was. I don't remember if KSI won or if it was a split decision. But I know KSI stomped that ass like Godzilla stomped out Donkey Kong's ass. So
Donkey Kong, because he was throwing barrels and shit.
The thing I'm most excited about with Black Widow is Taskmaster. I want to see Taskmaster. I think that'd be cool.
I'm really excited to see Taskmaster. I'm really excited to see Red Guardian. Like there. And it's also a spy movie. Like, I love these, like, the Marvel espionage movies, basically. Like, Winter Soldier was incredible. Like, it's still one of my top five favorite MCU movies.
Same. It might be my favorite MCU movie, honestly.
It's so good.
Yeah.
Like, it has some of the best fight scenes in, like, all of Marvel. It's so good.
I miss Bucky with the long hair, though. I do miss that.
He does, yeah, he definitely looked better with the long hair. I really did like
it. I guess I'm in the minority. I like him better with the short hair.
Most women seem to.
Lindsay, do you like me better with the short hair or the long hair?
Either way.
Neither one's good. Shelby, do you like me better with the long hair or the short hair?
You should do both. One side short, one side long.
No!
Party on the side.
Business on the other side.
I think you should try balls.
Turn this way. I'm serious. Turn this way. It's time to party.
It's like
half hip, skinhead.
One side of my head's in Congress. The other side of my head fucks 15-year-olds.
No.
Oh no.
No. You ain't got enough forehead for that.
You need another. Like you need a second side. You only said one side.
You need a fifth head.
All right, let's go to Shelby Chan. Shelby Chan, what's your first pick?
Wait.
All right, that was great.
Sorry.
Awesome.
It's probably my most favorite thing. It's a book called Bloodless, and it's by Douglas Preston and Lincoln Child, my favorite authors. So I'm just going to go with a book right off the bat.
Yay, books.
Books are great, but honestly, if you're going to buy one book this year, Cass, can you zoom in on that one book they should buy this year? It's Alexander, The Forging of a Warrior President.
Right there.
That's masterfully written. Masterfully.
Oh, God, that's so bad.
Talk to text, baby. It's the only way to go. So tell me about this book. What's it about?
Yeah, it's like a Nicolas Cage in a banana on a pillow.
Ha! I also saw that John Oliver bit.
No, I was. I'm sorry,
what?
I said, what's the book about? Tell me about the book. Sell me on it. Like we sold so many people on this Forging of a Warrior Horse book.
It's an Warrior ongoing Horse. Series. This is actually like book 20 in this saga. It's about this guy named Pendergast, and he's like the best detective in the world, and he goes to all the different states in the U.S. and I think even goes across seas, solves a bunch of crazy cases that shouldn't be even possible. A lot of them are supernatural, and a lot of the times, like, they're really well written. These two authors make it really suspenseful, and they do a really good job of not making any of the books like sound anything like the previous books, and they keep adding stuff to it that you're just like, all right, tell me more. Give me another book. I need more.
Cool. I like that. That works. All right, let's move on to Warrior Horse. Kaz, what's your what's something you're excited about this year?
The hope is that Expanse Season 6 comes out before the end of the year.
That's a sci-fi show, right?
Yeah, The Expanse.
Is it actually on sci-fi, or is it just a sci-fi show? Okay.
It's science fiction, but it's on Amazon Prime. Started on sci-fi. And then sci-fi tried to nix it, and then the one good thing Bezos has done is buy it and then continue it. And I don't know, it's probably one of my favorite science fiction television shows. Like, that's starting to peak up there with Star Trek.
And it's actually kind of cool, because that whole thing started as a forum RPG.
Yep. And then the books got written, like co-written, and it's just brilliantly done.
Cool.
Yeah. Apparently, Jonathan Atwood,
Jenny Atwood,
friend of the show.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, he was. I don't think he has a character that's mentioned in the series at all. But he actually did participate in that forum before. You know, it got big and everything.
That's badass. That is really badass. Michaela has a question. Oh. When it comes to books, Shelby, have you thought about buying any Chuck Tingle books?
Who's Chuck Tingle? What does he write about?
Just look up Chuck Tingle author, and check out some of his books. I think you might like them.
No, just don't do it.
Do it.
Don't do it.
Do it. Do it.
My handsome sentient face mask protects me despite the ridiculous conspiracy theories that he won't. Also, he pounds my butt.
Can I just put that one back up real quick? I don't think they saw that one. Pounded in the butt by the physical manifestation of awkward political dinner discussion over the Thanksgiving holiday. Chuck Tingle is a real author.
Wow.
Please also take note, in the background seems to be the Teletubby son grown up.
Pounded in the butt by Area 51 while attempting to storm it.
And when things get cold.
Oh, that one's kind of cute. That was kind of that's like the son that Ditto and I had, and that now he's like Papa, keep me warm.
Aww,
I'll never.
Pounded in the butt by the handsome sentient manifestation of my Twitch stream.
Two-time Hugo Award nominee, Chuck Tingle. Not pounded Jesus. By anything while I practice responsible social distancing.
Technically, this one calls him a two-time
handsome Russian T-Rex who also peed on his butt and then blackmailed him with the videos of his butt getting peed on.
This one's a two-time Hugo Award finalist.
Oh.
He moved up toward that.
Oh, let's go over to Seanan. Seanan, please save this segment. Can't do it.
Bigfoot pirates haunt my balls.
This is a book that will not be getting purchased and putting on the back wall here. I refuse.
Download it to your phone so you can take it with you everywhere.
Ebook worthy. Okay.
Jesse, can you please tell me the name of that book one more time?
I absolutely can, good buddy. Bigfoot Pirates Haunt My Balls.
By two-time Hugo Award finalist Chuck Tingle.
Personally, what about the Area 51 one? You know, while attempting to storm it,
you got pounded in the butt. So, all right, Tanner, prides himself on being the guy that can book the guests for the show. Tanner, book Chuck Tingle on the fucking show. Then we'll talk. You get me, Tingle. And then we'll talk.
I've become a spectator on this show.
Wear plain butt party.
All right, my first pick for media I'm excited about this year is really easy. I don't have to say much about it. It's Ghostbusters Afterlife. There.
Yes.
It's done.
I did put that one on there because I didn't even want to try to steal it from you.
Thank you. That's the only thing I'm like super duper excited about. Actually, there's a couple things I'm excited about. I don't have to tell you about Ghostbusters Afterlife. It is a continuation. It's a sequel to the second movie. It's a direct sequel. It has all the original cast, even though Harold Ramis passed away. He plays a big part in it. Paul Rudd's in it. It looks like a lot of fun. I cannot wait for Afterlife. I'm so excited. I'm going to see it 50 times. I might see it 69 times in the theater, honestly.
Ooh.
What?
Shelby.
What?
What's happening?
He doesn't even know.
What?
I'm losing my shit over here.
What are you talking about?
He don't even know.
The goddamn sex viewing.
The sex viewing. Isn't that's the goddamn sex viewing one of Chuck Tingle's books?
No, that's the goddamn butt pounding.
Pounded in the butt. Pounded in the butt by Ghostbusters Afterlife. Yeah. All right, Lindsay, please, for fuck's sake, save this.
I mean, I feel like it should be obvious what my main one for this year is. It's
Chuck
Pokemon
Tingle.
Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl.
Yeah, that's
because
it.
I have been waiting for so many freaking years for my Gen 4 remake.
Hey, Paul Rudd.
What the fuck's wrong with Paul Rudd? He's a national treasure.
What?
A national treasure. Apparently, Michaela is not watching the new Ghostbusters because it has Paul Rudd in it, and she hates him.
But look at you, and hate Paul Rudd. He never ages.
Right. Yeah,
and he seems like just the coolest dude.
Are you confusing him with someone else?
Maybe she just...
I don't know anything.
Maybe
Rudd's one of the few actors that hasn't done anything shitty.
Maybe, right. Maybe she just really hates the movie Mac like, and Me.
I was going to say, other than Troll Conan O'Brien.
Which is always fantastic. Yeah. Lindsay, I've got a problem with your pick.
Yeah.
The graphics for the characters look so weird.
They're chibi.
They sure are.
Wanted to recreate that classic feeling.
There's a picture of Matt Gaetz with his wig off after orgasm.
That's his vinegar strokes.
His what?
That's a League reference. I don't want to get into it. We can talk about it after the show.
How do you do this so quickly? I don't understand, man. That boy's got
some tools.
He's got some serious talent. Okay, so Lindsay's Diamond and Pearl, she's most excited about this year, and I know she's going to put a ton of time into it because she's a Pokemaniac. Let's go back to the top. Yeah. Jesse Kimball.
My next one. Mass Effect Legendary Edition.
Yeah. Yeah, you damn right. You damn right.
So they're remaking all three Mass Effect games, like remastering them, making them look real pretty, and re-releasing them on next-gen platforms.
One especially.
And I'm really excited about it.
One looks really good.
Because I've tried to go back and replay the first Mass Effect game, and it's very difficult. I love the game still. But it is. There's a lot about it that's real dated. I'm really, really excited about this. I would love to play through them because I never did finish 3. Mm. So I would really like to just take another character through all 3 games because that's one thing that's really cool about Mass Effect. Like you make one character and it transfers through the games. Ultimately, it doesn't matter, which is a bummer. But for the first few games, it's a really fun mechanic.
Up until the end of part 3, you're solid. You're solid.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Right.
Shelbican. Shelby Kuhn.
Free Guy, which is
Ryan Reynolds.
A movie, Ryan Reynolds. Yeah.
That movie looks fantastic.
Yeah, I'm really excited about it. It's about a bank teller in a video game who becomes self-aware. Like, he breaks free of the program, essentially. And just
about this one. Yeah.
Yeah, he's like, I'm going to do my own thing now. And apparently there's a couple YouTubers who are making cameo appearances, and I'm kind of excited because Jacksepticeye is one of them, and I actually really like him.
I also like Jacksepticeye. Maria turned me around on him. I hated most YouTubers until Maria came into my life, and then I started to like Jacksepticeye and Markiplier and guys like that, so I don't hate them anymore. So I appreciate that. And Jacksepticeye is Irish. So Jesse, you gotta love that.
You gotta respect a good Irishman.
Yeah, that's why we love Tanner.
Rule?
That's why we love Tanner. Anyway, let's move on to the Kaz man.
Well, we got five, and we've done one.
We've done one. Welcome to hell.
Okay. Well, I'm just making sure I've got some runway left. French Dispatch. I like Wes Anderson movies.
I'm so shocked. If you like Wes Anderson movies, you've never watched the Midnight Coterie of Sinister Intruders. That is my favorite Wes Anderson film.
That's a good one.
Personally, I am a Bill Murray fan, so I'm looking forward to.
Is he in it?
And Tilda Swinton. Yeah. Tilda Swinton, Bill Murray, Jeffrey Wright, Christopher Waltz, who's also one of my favorites.
I'm surprised you didn't say Jason Schwartzman, Owen Wilson, you know, the usual gang.
Luke is the better Wilson. Wow. I'm not going to bring up Owen.
Wow.
I still like Owen, and he's in the new Loki show. He looks like he's having fun.
Wow.
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 Wow. Anyway. My next
apparently
one.
There's a World Warcraft add-on.
Wow.
That every time you get a crit, it's like Owen Wilson's is wow.
Wow.
That would be amazing.
Shelby, have you read the book Pounded in the Butt by Owen Wilson saying wow by Chuck Tingle?
No, I have not.
The manifestation of Owen Wilson's wow.
Oh, okay.
I need you to create me a picture of a Bigfoot pirate.
What?
Kaz, all right, no, I got an assignment for you. Kaz, I got an assignment for me. Make up a fake cover for Pounded in the Butt by the Physical Manifestation of Owen Wilson saying, wow, by Chuck Tingle. That's what I need you to do. Make the fake cover. That's your assignment. While he's doing that, serious time. All right, serious time. Watch my face. Watch my face. Serious. We're going back to serious. My next pick, Candyman. I want to watch.
Is that going to finally come out this year?
Yes. It is a sequel to the original Candyman film, I think, because Tony Todd is in it. And I think Tony Todd is playing Candyman in the movie once again. I am so excited for this film. I wanted to watch it so badly. I'm actually glad they pushed it back, because if they hadn't pushed it back, it would have released right after I had my breakup. And I did same thing with Ghostbusters Afterlife, and I could not have enjoyed it. So I'm glad they pushed it back to where I'm in a much better place. I want to see this movie so bad. I'm a huge fan of the original Candyman film. It's one of my favorite horror films, and it's really good. So it holds excited. Up. It does. The first one does. Not so much Farewell to the Flesh and whatever the hell the second one was called. I don't even remember. Was it just
Candyman 2? I honestly forgot that those movies happened.
The second and third
one. I removed them from my memory entirely.
The first Candyman is awesome, though. So, yeah, Candyman.
I also love the first Candyman is just a great like look into the 90s and what people were afraid of.
Mm-hmm. And Kaz has a special connection to the original Candyman because they filmed that movie at Cabrini Greens in Chicago. And Kaz... Tingle me bingle. What? Wow. What?
Tingle me bingle. Wow.
Wow.
Chuck Tingle.
Wow.
But yes. What were you saying, Shannon?
I was telling them about Cabrini Greens and you.
Oh, I used to live down the road from there for a while.
He did, which is pretty badass. All right, Lindsay, what you got number two?
My next one.
Hold on, before you say that. Now that Kaz and we've been talking about it, when I look at that bird, all I can see is him going, "Wow,
wow,
wow."
Yeah, Toby, I need a voice bubble coming out of it. Wow,
wow. Nope, she's done. All right, Lindsay, what's your second pick?
My second pick is the webcomic Lore Olympus that I really enjoy is getting its first physical edition of a book this October, and I intend to buy it.
Wow.
That thing you've been reading for free on the internet?
Yes, but I want to support the artist and get a copy of it.
It's usually the opposite. Oh, that's some Inception shit right there. Oh.
Wow.
Wow.
Well,
wow.
I know what we're going to be saying on Call of Duty all night tonight. Wow.
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 I'm not giving my coloring page a voice bubble. I'm sorry. Plus, it's a Pokemon. The most it could do would be going, blue.
No, that's clearly. Wow. You put a, put a mop top on that Pokemon, and that's definitely Owen Wilson. All right, Lindsay, what's your second one?
I just told you
I wasn't paying attention. Oh yeah, Lower Olympus. Okay, sorry. I might be a little.
How many
stupid.
Have you drank?
Like four? I don't know.
Let's out think. Of the five that are in your fridge.
Damn, that means I'm almost out. Let's
like
go back
2%
to just
alcohol.
There's no alcohol content on this. Look at this. I think I'm just tired. What do we got here? There is. I can't see because it's too dark. It contains alcohol. It barely does. Let's go back to Jesse.
Jesse, Diablo 2 Resurrected is supposed to hit this year.
I'm gonna hit you with the Alec Baldwin Donald Trump. Yeah. But isn't Diablo 4 also coming out this year?
No. It was originally supposed to, but it's been pushed.
Fucking Blizzard.
So instead they're giving you a cleanup of an old classic.
Yeah. Because they lost 200 people. Because there's you a motherfucker, though I guess at that point it would have been the motherfucker of last week. Did you hear about that? Activision Blizzard CEO laid off 200 people, then gave himself a $200 million raise.
Also hired someone from the Trump cabinet to head up one of their top positions.
Such bullshit.
Anyway, Diablo 2 looks fantastic. Shelby Chan, what do you got?
My Time at Sandrock. It's a game. I don't know if anyone's heard of My Time at Portia, but I love that game. It's like a farming, building, fun game. This one is basically that, but you're kind of rebuilding an old West style area. You take a train out to this place. It's in the middle of a desert. You're rebuilding like the entire town, essentially, rather than just
sounds like something Shannon would like.
So it's My Time at Portia, but it's a Western.
It's called My Time at Sandrock.
I'm going to look that up. That sounds really cool. Yeah, that's something I'm definitely interested in. Yeah. All right. Kaz.
My next one is going to be... And this is going to be kind of an out left field one, but Antlers.
Oh, yeah.
Which is kind of a... It's a Guillermo del Toro produced. It's not directed.
Kerry Russell. Yeah.
Yes. I was looking at a preview of that earlier. That looks freaking... freaky as hell.
Yeah, it's about the Wendigo, and they don't do enough Wendigo horror films. So yeah, I am
the Wendigo.
And this is, I mean, this is a legit looking one too. You don't see it much in the trailer, but when you do see it, it is a giant rotting monster. I mean, it looks amazing.
Yep.
Yeah, I was. That's another one that they pushed back last year. I'm so stoked for that one. I want to see that one really, really bad too. So yeah, good call. Good call. Man, those were the only two that I could remember. And I didn't write anything down, so help me out, Lindsay.
Surely there's something else you're looking forward to. The new Call of Duty.
Nah.
It's gonna be Sledge. You actually like Sledge. Yeah.
The open world Pokemon game via like Breath of the Wild.
It's not this year.
It's not coming out this year.
Yeah.
It isn't?
Nope.
Nope.
Okay, well, never mind.
All right, this is a basic one, and it doesn't really matter, but I am excited for it. WrestleMania. WrestleMania is this weekend, and even though I'm not as excited about this WrestleMania as I've been about past WrestleManias, it's still WrestleMania. It's the only time of the year I get those like little kid wrestling vibes, like I'm excited. So it's a cultural event, and I'm excited for that reason. It's one of those times that all of my friends on Facebook, well, most of them, because a lot of my friends on Facebook are from the wrestling world. They're just ties I've made in professional wrestling. So it's that one time of the year we all kind of come together and talk about something. So it is exciting.
this weekend, Saturday and Sunday. It's a two-night event. NXT was last night and tonight, which I'm missing night two. I'll watch it later on Peacock. But yeah, what I really miss, though, one of the things I miss most of all is our wrestling get-togethers at the store when we would all...
Yeah.
We'd all hang out, we'd play video games, we'd eat pizza, and we'd watch wrestling. Though we haven't done that since COVID, and that I'm
just about
that.
Everybody's vaccinated now. We could probably do it again.
I don't know, man. Part of my enjoyment from that was certain people, and without them, I just don't know if I'll feel the same way about it. It's the same reason I don't get in the legendary group chat anymore. It's just when that person left, it kind of changed my outlook on a lot of things. So. I don't know if I'd feel the same way. It's a nostalgic thing, but I don't think I'd want to relive it. I'm perfectly happy just sitting in my chair with the blanket up to here, watching stuff by myself. Okay. Let's go.
I miss the old backyard wrestling days.
WrestleMania, right? Like when I... Mm-hmm. Who was it that Irish whipped me into Bird Dog's brand new truck and I bent the side of it?
Macho. Wait, what was it? How'd it go?
Bird Dog was like, oh man, show. It was like matches over, show's over, match or something over. Like that. Yeah, we broke his fucking truck.
Here you go. Here's this is for y'all. This is for y'all.
It's too small. I can't read it.
Wow.
Oh, hold on. Hold on. I'll fix it.
I'm making my screen bigger.
Wow.
I like the wig.
Wow. God damn, stop it. Lindsay, what's your next one? What's your third one?
Are we up to me already?
Hell yeah.
You just... Okay. Well, my third one comes out at the end of the month. Pokemon Snap.
Hell yeah.
I'll be taking some photos of Pokemon.
That's where you pay $60 to do what you can do in Pokemon Go.
With different graphics.
Oh,
or take your ass to the zoo and take pictures of real Pokemon.
The stingrays opened back up at the St. Louis Zoo.
Catch them all. Tigers too.
We actually talked
about going that long ago.
Our courage will pull us through. I'd love to go back to the zoo. The stingrays are awesome. They're so slippery.
Yeah. They were talking about trying to go before it gets hot.
It's already hot,
especially since. Well, I mean, today was really cool.
I was sweating.
Were you?
It was humid.
Anyway.
And today was like 52 or something like that.
It was like 80.
It was nearly chilly outside.
You tell that to my workplace. I was uncomfortably warm.
Hello, everybody.
And that's saying something if I'm uncomfortably warm.
Oh, what did they end up naming that dumbass little rabbit?
Buck.
Buck. Yeah, it was it. Buck.
Buck. Because
I think it was you that had the idea for Edge.
Yeah, because it was the Edge card. Because call him Edge the Bunny. Yeah.
Looks like the Reddit character. Card.
Jesse, did you see the post I made on Sunday for Easter?
No.
You should go back. It's on Podzilla's Facebook page. Go back and watch it. It's me basically wishing everyone a happy Easter, and then I throw it to this little guy who pops up on the screen, and in one of those funny voices says, "Fuck our employees." Wow.
Yeah. That's
what he'd say now is wow. Anyway, Jesse, what's your next pick?
Wow. Stranger Things season 4.
Wow.
Wow.
Is that coming out this year?
Yeah.
Yay.
Supposed to be. And I love Stranger Things. And I'm really excited for this season.
I don't know. I feel like it's dragging at this point. I still like it, but like I'm less interested in each season.
I'm probably going to need a refresher again at this point.
You don't feel like it goes like too long between seasons now, and I start to forget everything.
Forget about it. Mm-hmm.
What's up, Quentin?
Yeah.
Quentin says, have no idea what's going on. Just trying to log on to show some love. We appreciate that. All right, let me recap. Shannon has been accused of having sexual attractions for Dittos. Everything says, wow. And... And Chuck Tingle is our author of the week. Cass, can you show? There it is. Pounded in the butt by the physical manifestation of awkward political dinner discussion over the Thanksgiving holiday. It's one of our favorite books here on Podzilla 1985. Shelby introduced us to it.
What about the Bigfoot Pirates?
Oh, what was it again?
That's the Bigfoot controversial one.
Okay. My balls.
Wow. All right.
Wow.
Shelby, please. Shelby, please.
All right, something, another cute game, Baldo. It's inspired by The Legend of Zelda and Studio Ghibli films, so it's got that vibe and that appearance where everything's kind of soft and cute. It's an RPG that's full of puzzles, exploration, and combat. And it's set in a like hand-drawn open world setting. Which,
it's a shame that I suck at non-Pokemon video games.
You do.
Because that sounds like something I'd probably try and play. Keyword being try.
Yeah, I think it was originally supposed to come out last year, but it hadn't dropped. I don't know. So it got pushed back.
COVID fucked everybody over. Yeah. No doubt. Kaz, what do you got?
What number are we on?
Three. Welcome to hell.
Four.
This is number four.
Four.
Is this four? Oh, thank God. Okay.
Oh, darn. I've actually got three left. That's okay.
You can take one of mine because I don't.
Oh, okay. Actually, all right. I'm going to start with this one because this is a sure what I'm very curious about is the Green Knight. 14th century Arthurian poem. Really weird out there kind of artsy film. Definitely going to require a Google from anybody out there, but the preview looked pretty fucking cool.
All right. I am excited about this. Taylor Swift's new album comes out this Friday. It's not actually her new album.
Didn't she just have one?
Well, she re-recorded her original album, Fearless, and she's putting it on Spotify because, as I don't know if you know the story, I think I said the story, she doesn't own the masters to her own music. Her record company sold them out from under her, so she doesn't have the rights to her own music. So she's re-recording all of her original music and re-releasing it, and I'm a big fan of that because, one, that's fucked up, and two, I love Taylor Swift, so... Her album Fearless, it's called Taylor's Version, and it drops this Friday. I'm very excited about that. I'm a Swiftie. Okay, that was great.
Thank you. There
you go.
Shannon used Swift.
If you ask me who do I like more, Taylor Swift or Poppy, I would have to say 100%. Wow. All right, Lindsay.
My next one, I'm pretty sure actually came out in Japan last month, but we haven't gotten it yet. So Sailor Moon Eternal.
Yeah.
Which is the movie based on the fourth season of the series. Want to see.
You want to be
pretty.
The very best.
Very best.
Oh no, Jesse put the cover. Is this the actual cover of the book?
So it was what popped up on Google Images.
Hold on, I gotta put it on the main show. It has to happen.
That don't put that shit near me.
I'm gonna put it right next to Kaz.
Don't. Really.
I'm sorry, Mr. Ditto.
Because I know you're gonna leave that up for the rest of the show.
I won't do that. I'll put it right in the middle so that way no one's being punished too much. This is the award-winning book Bigfoot Pirates Haunt My Balls by Chuck Tingle.
Wow. I like the eye patch.
Yeah, the eye patch really just completes
it. That sells it.
That sells me. At first, I didn't think he was a Bigfoot pirate.
Of course not.
I also like that the Bigfoot pirate is just a gorilla with a human body.
You see, he's got an earring, too.
I hate my life. When the doctor asked me why I'm suicidal, I should have just advertised the show. All right.
Just give them the list of Chuck Tingle books.
No, just tell them next time you're upset. Like, listen, Pirate Bigfoot.
Haunt my balls. My doctor would probably nudge me. She would probably nudge me and say, well, at least they're getting some action again, right?
Or they'd be like, we have you on the absolute wrong medication. There's a different type we need to be giving you.
Oh, wow. All right. Back up to... who the fuck's turn is it? Is it Lindsay's? Or is it mine? It's mine. Yeah, because Kaz did the poem movie.
Yeah, and I said Sailor Moon. So what... Because you said Taylor Swift.
I said Taylor Swift. That's right. Okay, back to Jesse. Last one. Thank God.
Oh, all right, cool. The Orville Season 3.
That is Seth MacFarlane's parody of Star Trek.
It's not a parody.
No.
No. Kaz, it has to be Haunt.
Oh.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, no, it's not a parody, and that's what I thought originally too, that it was a parody of Star Wars. It's legitimately not. It's an actual, like, it's basically a Star Trek show with some comedy in it. And it's really, really good. Goddamn that Ditto.
I'm really sad. I really enjoyed having Kaz back in my life and on the show. I'm sad tonight's his last episode. He won't be staying with us anymore. That's unfortunate. Let's go with it.
Wow.
Shelby. Do the joke, Shelby. Do the bit.
She can't. You broke her too much.
No. So my pick is the movie Spiral. It's basically like a reboot of the Saw series, just, you know, before they got real bad.
From the Book of Saw, starring and directed, I think, by Chris Rock, right?
It's directed by Darren Bousman.
Yeah, that's what I said. That's what I meant.
But Chris Rock and Samuel L. Jackson is in it, so.
But Chris Rock had some part in the creation, right? If I remember correctly, like, it's his idea or something.
It might have been, but it doesn't. When I looked it up, it didn't say anything. I can look it up again, though.
Because I remember him being, he was like one of the driving forces behind the movie. He was big into it. So, oh, dear God.
No.
Oh, no. God.
What have you done?
That is horrifying.
That really is. That really is going to haunt my balls.
Like, it also looks like it's a completely different pitch for that Ditto.
It looks looks like it's forming into Matt Gaetz so he can fuck himself.
Oh,
that's
so he helped with the story.
He helped with the story. Okay, I thought so. Oh my god. Yeah, I actually want to see this. I'm not a fan of Saw. I like the first movie, and I appreciate what they did with some of the other ones, but I've never been a huge fan of it. But I really do want to see this one. I think it looks really good.
The first two Saw movies, and then after that, I was like, this is just torture.
Literally. It was just torture porn at that point. Don't watch them. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. In this one, didn't you say it's like Chris Rock and Samuel L. Jackson in this one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's not actually about Jigsaw. Like, it's it's got time. No,
It's set in the series, but right. It's a completely different kind of movie.
It's basically like someone was like, oh, I like how this dude killed people. I'm going to do something similar, but I'm not going to be him.
To me, it's got that Prometheus feeling to it, where it's got they said it had the same DNA as Alien, but it wasn't an Alien film. Something like that. You know what I mean? He wants to play a wow. All right, Kaz, last one. What do you got?
I am looking at, it's an interesting one, coming off of
and Kaz is gone.
Kaz.
The Concrete Cowboy. So Idris Elba and Caleb.
Say it one more time, Kaz. You blacked out there for a second.
Wait, did we lose me?
For a second,
a little bit, yeah.
We lost me. Okay, sorry about that. Concrete Cowboy, Idris Elba, and Caleb McLaughlin from Stranger Things.
Yeah, it's out. He's on Netflix. Yeah, it's available now.
Well, fuck it. I retract that one. I retract that one with a Hail Mary hope that it actually works out well, but I doubt it. I got little faith in it as the Cowboy Bebop real version.
I'm excited about it.
I want to see it, though.
Yeah.
I love Cowboy Bebop.
Yeah, I'm curious to see where that turns out, but I'm withholding my excitement.
I like the cast. I think the cast is good. Mm-hmm. I wasn't sold on John Cho as Spike Spiegel at first, but I really like John Cho. So I feel like he's too old for the role. That's the only problem I have with
really?
It.
Really?
Because he's, what is he, his early 40s, mid 40s?
Yeah.
And I always saw Spike Spiegel as like a mid 20s kind of guy. Maybe I'm wrong. Lindsay, how old was Spike Spiegel?
Like late 30s.
Yeah, like because he always had the appearance of a 20 something, but like he has the story and personality of someone in their 40s.
We're gonna find out. I don't know.
Lindsay's gonna look it up. Lindsay will show us the way.
I'm.
Do you know the way, Lindsay?
On my yes.
Speak on the fake queen.
Oh no, I'm looking. Spike is 27 years old.
Oh. Late 20s.
But I think John Cho will do a great job with it, so I have faith. My last thing, the thing I'm looking forward to most this year, is the arrest and trial of Matt Gaetz. Oh, I'm not even kidding. If they bust Matt Gaetz and put his ass in jail, I'm going to dance the fucking jig on the top of the Sears Tower. I will be so happy. Fuck that rat-faced motherfucker. Oh, I hate his fucking guts. I hope they fucking nail him to the wall. Just like I wanted Donald Trump to lose the election so badly, I want Matt Gaetz to get fucking arrested so badly. That's why I don't talk about it, because I'm afraid I'll jinx it. I don't want to jinx him getting fucked over. Fuck Matt Gaetz. Oh my God, I hope the worst thing... I hope all the bad things in life happen to you and only you. Hate, 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 hate. All right.
Hate.
Last one, Lindsay, what do you got?
My last one... I really want to see Spider-Man No Way Home.
I only want to see Spider-Man. It's supposed to be.
December 17th is its current release date.
Oh, shit.
I only want to see it if they follow through with the rumor of Andrew Garfield and Tobey Maguire being in it. Even though Tom Holland said they're not, but they also keep things on the hush. So
we made a joke about that on Nerd Up, where like Tom Holland said no. And part of us was like wondering if they told Tom Holland that they're not going to be in there, because that motherfucker has a history of leaking shit on the internet.
Yes, he does.
Or the other thing that's running around is that he does know, but because he has that, he's pretending that no, they're not.
No, like he's
like a young Mark Ruffalo, just gives shit away.
He gets a different script than everybody else.
Well, there is also. I think it was a Twitter thing that someone was thanking a bunch of the people involved, and one of the ones on there was a stunt double for one of the other Spider-Men from their movies. So it's a possibility. It's nothing like hard in stone, but
I'm hoping
possible leak info.
I'm hoping. I'm absolutely hoping. And that's going to do it for us tonight here on the show. We're going to wrap it up. I know Quentin asked, he said, what do you think about the new voting laws in Georgia? There's not enough time for us to go deep on that. I will say one of the stupidest things is this rule that you can't give water or food to people standing in line. It's one of the dumbest things I've ever heard in my life. It's
what?
Did you notice that one of their rebuttals was, well, somebody can order like DoorDash. So that means a DoorDash motherfucker is going to get arrested.
Yeah, some of it's ridiculous. I mean, a lot of it's ridiculous. But like I said, we don't have enough time to talk about that right now. Quentin, I'll tell you what. We'll do a show soon, and we'll talk about it, and we'll get your opinion on
it. The irony is Kentucky actually did a increase in voting rights. They actually expanded voting rights in Kentucky.
Here's other things we need to talk about at some point soon. We need to talk about Joe Biden's new infrastructure plan. We need to talk about the new gun laws that he's putting in, the executive action. There's a whole bunch to discuss, but I always said I'm not going to talk about politics very much anymore on After Dark. This is supposed to be a show about fun and dittos. So that's going to do it for us tonight. We're going to be back tomorrow with Horse Time. Fuck that face. Wow. Until then.
Wow.
Until then, for myself, for Jesse Kimball, for Shelby Chan, for Lindsay, for the Kaz Man, and for that fucking face, and for Owen Wilson, of course, thank you guys for tuning in. We'll be back tomorrow for Horse Time. It'll be a lot of fun. Until then, you guys take care of yourselves. And Shelby, take us out.
Goodbye.
You cut out halfway. One more time. Shelby, take us out.
Goodbye.
Good enough.
Gonna do it again.